Yes, our July read on Chicago PMI is certainly nothing to be proud of. 44.4. Fours are wild, but the number is far from wild. Contraction mode for the second month in a row. Last month, 49.7 remains unrevised. This is now the lowest level since December of 2015, which, by the way, was the same comp as our last month's look. So it really is something to pay attention to. We've seen some of the regional manufacturing numbers diverging as of late, some showing strength, some not. This is definitely in the not column. We all know that today, of course, is the second day of the Fed's two-day meeting. We certainly do expect that we will see a quarter point decrease, first since 2008. And, of course, everybody's looking and listening, of course, will be to Q&A with the chairman to see if this is the beginning of an easing cycle, although maybe he doesn't have enough information to go there in particular, but definitely to see if it's a more of a one-and-done hawkish type statement and press conference or not. And in lieu of that, it's interesting. Look at a two-day of two-year, and it's subtle. See the right side, the second day is lower. We're down about 3 basis points in twos. But if you go to 10-year and 30-year, they're much closer to unchanged. We're now down 1 basis point in 10-year note yields. The point is we're getting a little bit of curve steepening. This is a good thing, and it makes sense considering what the Fed's doing today. The big question will be if there's any sustainability to that notion, because whether it's the dollar or trying to make the curve less inverted or non-inverted, it certainly seems though data isn't figuring as prominently in some of these recent Fed speaks and ultimate decision. If we look at Fed fund futures themselves, and I'll go to December, which includes the logjam of all the previous meetings, don't pay attention so much to percentages. What I really want to draw your attention to is since the last Fed meeting in July, those prices have gone down. Down, of course, means less chance of cumulative eases. So that 50 was priced out. We'll have to monitor some of these back months. Finally, 1 week of the dollar index. It had a good day yesterday, giving back a little today. Couldn't quite take out those April 2019 highs at 98.25.